You're welcome again. In this video, you will learn to expand double brackets. If you don't know how to expand single bracket, just watch my previous video, how to expand single brackets. Here we have this example, x plus 4, x plus 3. This is what we mean when we talk about expanding double brackets. Here we have two brackets right next to each other without any sign in between them. As you know, when we expand brackets, it involves multiplication. So when we talk about double brackets, that means we need to multiply everything in the first bracket to everything in the second bracket. So let's start. Firstly, take this example. So we are going to multiply everything in the first bracket to everything in the second. So what we can do, take this x, multiply it to the entire bracket. This can be written as x in bracket this entire, x plus 3. Then we have positive sign here, we'll put plus 4 times this entire bracket, x plus 3. Now this seems as the single brackets that we have done before, so we can simplify the way we can. X times x, you know that, x squared. Then x times 3 is 3x, and then 4 times x is 4x, then 4 times 3 is 12. Now you have expanded the bracket. Now we need to see what we can simplify here. As you can see, x squared cannot be combined to these two terms. What we can simplify here is 3x and 4x. They are like term, so we can put them together. So x squared plus 3 plus 4 is 7, so 7x plus 12. The common mistake is students, they collect x squared and x. They cannot be collected together as they are different. This is x squared and this is x. So what we can simplify, we can put them together is 3x and 4x. Now let's work on this example. Again we have double brackets here. We'll multiply everything to the first bracket with the everything to the second bracket. So it is x in bracket, the entire other bracket, x plus 7 plus 5, again then x plus 7. So x times x is x squared plus, then x times 7, 7x, 5 times x, 5x, 5 times 7, 35. We need not to worry about the negative signs because we have all the positive sign here. Now, after expanding, now we need to see what terms can be collected together. As you can see, we have 7x and 5x like terms. We can collect them together, 7 plus 5, 12x plus 35. So this is your final answer after expanding double bracket. Now let's work on this expression. As you can see, we got two negative signs here. Let's see what difference does it make when we have two negative signs. So again, the process is same. X times the entire bracket, second bracket, negative sign, negative 4, then entire bracket, x minus 3. Now let's expand. X squared, 3 times, negative 3 times x, negative 3x, 4 times, negative 4 times x, negative 4x. Now this is negative 4 times negative 3. We have two negative signs together and in multiplication, so it is positive 12. Now we have expanded the bracket. Now we'll look what terms can be collected together. So we can see here we have two like terms, x and x with 3 and 4, but it both are negative. So we are adding them, x squared minus 7x plus 12x. So this is your final answer. Now try this one, x minus 6 and x minus 5. Process is same. You understood now? X times entire bracket, the second one, x minus 5, then negative sign, negative with 6, multiply to the second bracket, x minus 5. So when you open the bracket, this is x squared minus 5x, negative 6 times x. It is negative 6x. Negative 6x. Then negative 6 times negative 5. So negative and negative together multiplied, it will become positive 30. So this is positive 30 here. Now after expanding the bracket, again we look for the like terms, x and x. So x squared, as they both are negative, we will add them and keep the sign. This is 11x plus 30. So this is the final answer after expanding and simplification. Now this is the final example of this tutorial. You can see the difference. It is x plus 5 squared. So most common answer students give is x squared plus 25. So which is not correct. So let's see what is the correct answer and how to work it out. As you know, when something is squared, that means we multiply itself twice. So this expression is x plus 5. So we'll write it down twice, x plus 5. Now you know the process. So it will be x squared plus 5 plus 5 x squared plus x plus 5. Sorry, I said x squared. So when you open the bracket, it will be x squared plus 5x plus again 5x plus 5 times 5, 25. So now like terms, 5 and then 5x and 5x. So it is x squared plus 10x plus 25. So this is the final answer, not x squared plus 25. So now you have learned how to expand double brackets. In the next video, I will teach you how to expand the double brackets with the negative sign or mixed signs. Okay, bye.